Hello students, let's begin our today's session. Lesson 1.4, have you thought of the verb have? In this lesson, we are going to mainly focus on the verb have. We are going to learn the multiple uses of the verb have. But before that, we are going to see what is the difference between has, have and had. Has is used for singular noun or pronoun, for example, he has, she has, it has, etc. Have is used for plural noun or pronoun, for example, I, you, we, they. Now you'll say I and you is not plural, but here it is. Had is the past tense of have. For example, they had, he had, I had, etc. Have has six multiple uses. They are to show possession, to show ownership, to refer to events, activities and experiences, to indicate relationship, to refer to eating or drinking, and to refer to physical and medical condition. Let's see each in detail. First, to show possession. It indicates what a person possess or have. For example, my friend has a pet cat. Here, friend is a singular noun, so we make use of the verb has. Has shows what the friend possess, that is a cat. Let's see more examples. I have a new motorcycle. I is a plural noun, so we make use of have. Have shows what the person possesses, that is motorcycle. Second, the children have same school bag. Here, children is a plural noun, so we make use of the verb have. Have shows what the child or children possess, that is same school bag. Third, my neighbor has two dogs. Neighbor is a singular noun, so we make use of the verb has. Has shows what the neighbor possess, that is two bags. Next, to show ownership. It indicates what a person has brought. For example, a school has six computers. Here, school is a singular noun, so we make use of the verb has. Has shows what the school owns, that is six computers. Let's see more examples. First, my building has two lifts. Here, building is a singular noun, so we make use of the verb has. Has shows what the building owns, that is two lifts. Second, the lake has four houseboats. Here, lake is a singular noun, so we make use of the verb has. Has shows what the lake owns, that is four houseboats. Third, our school library has many books. Here, school library is a singular noun, so we make use of the verb has. Has shows what the school library owns, that is many books. Next, to refer to events, activities and experiences. It indicates to a particular event, activity or experiences that has taken place in a person's life. For example, I am going to have a bath in the river. I is a plural pronoun here, so we make use of the verb have. Have shows the experience of the person. Let's see more examples. First one, we had a wonderful time at the picnic. Picnic is an event, so to indicate that we make use of the verb had. Second, they have a fun fair in their building every year. Here, fun fair is again an event, and to indicate that we again make use of the verb had. Next, third one, our children had a drawing exam yesterday. Drawing exam is an activity, and to indicate that we make use of the verb had. Next, to indicate relationship. It shows the relationship between two things. For example, I have two sisters. I is a plural pronoun, so we make use of the verb have. Have shows the relationship between the two girls. More examples. First, do you have any sibling? To indicate a relationship, we make use of the verb have. Second, I have an aunt who is a singer. To indicate the relationship between the person and his aunt, we make use of the verb have. She has a baby. To indicate the relationship between she and the baby, we make use of the verb has. Next, to refer to eating or drinking. It indicates about eating and drinking. For example, we have breakfast at 8 a.m. Here, we is the plural pronoun and so we make use of the verb have. Have indicates what a person is eating. Let's see more examples. First, may I have the last piece of cake? Here, to indicate eating, we make use of the verb have. Second, have some juice if you are thirsty. Here, to indicate drinking, we make use of the verb have. Third, you can have this chocolates. To indicate eating, we make use of the verb have. Next, to refer to a medical or physical condition. It shows someone's medical and physical condition. For example, I have a headache. Here, I is a plural pronoun, so we make use of the verb have. Have indicates the physical and medical condition of a person. Let's see more examples. First one, my friend had fever last night. To indicate the physical and medical condition of the fever of the friend, we make use of the verb had. Second, my mother has a toothache quite often. To indicate the physical and medical condition of mother, we make use of the verb has. I have a broken nail which is painful. Here, to indicate the physical condition of the person, we make use of the verb have. Hope the concept is clear to you. Thank you.